Hello, today I want to teach you how I became a professional salsa dancer, basically from scratch. I came from knowing absolutely nothing about dancing to now becoming a professional salsa dancer. I've had the opportunity to go and travel over 20 countries in very numerous cities to be able to teach salsa. And I'll also give you a few tips on how I made this journey faster for me and how you can achieve better results, whether your goal is to become a professional salsa dancer or just become a great social dancer or a great performer, or you're just curious about the scene and you want to learn as much as you can as fast as possible. I will teach you that today. Now, the first tip that I can give you is to really prioritize your learning over many other things that I see are very common that people prioritize when they start to dance salsa. So if you really want to be serious about your training, I'd say always keep it your number one priority over maybe having, you know, a great time in your studio with your friends that you just made, or having fun drinking and social dancing. Of course, having fun and making friends is a beautiful part of our community. But if, for example, you're in a situation where maybe you're in a studio that doesn't provide the same knowledge as maybe another studio near you, it's very important that you are not afraid and that you are able to make that switch. Because again, we want to prioritize your learning and make sure that you're spending your time and your resources as efficiently as possible. And you know, just maybe because you don't want to make your director mad at you, you're just gonna stay there despite being able to find way better training somewhere else. I think now I've been dancing for 8 years. I will turn 9 years in a couple of months, in October 2024. I will complete my 9th year salsa dancing. So I would say that is a relatively short time to become a professional dancer or artist. As I said before, I will try to tell you all the information and all the tips that I felt made me go through this journey as fast as possible, because I didn't dance salsa when I was a kid. I think I started at a pretty older age, so I felt like I had to really catch up if it's really what I wanted to do for a living. And I'm very grateful that I'm able to live 100% of what I do from dance. So I will just share with you my experiences and where I've been. So for those of you who don't know, I was born and raised in Costa Rica. I currently live now in New York City, but I was born and raised in Costa Rica. And my first school that I was there, it was called, well, it's called because it still exists, it's called Mambo Son Dance Center, and it's run by Javier Rodriguez. He is a very passionate mambo lover, and he's the one responsible for bringing me into this world. I basically met him as he was giving out flyers in a food court mall. I just happened to be there that day. He gave me a flyer with a special discount for students, and that's how I went to the school, checked it out, and fell in love completely with salsa dancing and never stopped from that day. Here is actually a clip of me going in my first day to the studio. I was in this studio for 3 years, and the best things I feel I was able to learn from this school is the love for the music, the culture, that is very important to learn about the history, about this musical genre, to be able to connect with it at a much deeper level. As well as this school was very social dance oriented, so I was able to get pretty decent, I would say, at partner work and learning the basics for footwork. They were incredible at teaching you the basics and basically making sure that you were set up to be able to social dance wherever you wanted to go in the world. Doesn't matter if you were gonna be in a social in Japan or in Italy or in New York City. If you learn in this studio, I will promise you that you will be able to defend yourself wherever you go. Now for my second stage, my second studio that I was part of was called Rincón Salsero. Now this school now doesn't exist, but the main instructors from this previous school now opened their new school called Salsa del Barrio. So they have the same essence and I'd say more knowledge now that time has gone by. So they're incredible. Make sure to look them up, Salsa del Barrio, Costa Rica. And in this studio, I was able to learn the art of performing. So as my first studio was a little bit more social oriented, I would say this one was more performance oriented, which is an art form that I wanted to improve in. They were very focused in competitions, in performing as a soloist, as performing with a partner, doing a team shine of only men, doing pro-am, couples teams, professional teams. So this school really taught me about the importance of projection, about lines, about technique, about the performance element of the salsa world, which is something completely different than the social dance aspect of the dance. So I wanted to start competing and performing. This is the school that would usually sweep everybody's trophies, and like, they would win. I'm not kidding, they would win everything, because I feel this is a school that has perfected the art of learning about salsa competitions. So that's why I chose to be them, and I was able to be there for 3 years. Also, they have a very good background in Afro-Cuban culture and everything that has to do with Afro-Cuban and rumba as well, which is really good for you to be able to control the way you move your body and the way that you isolate your muscles and your movement. That is certainly something that helped me a lot. Even though I specialize more with mambo nowadays, definitely from Afro-Cuban, I was able to learn how to move every little part of my body to control it in a way that I wanted. And finally, I was in another school where I currently teach now. So this is the first school that I was actually giving classes for the first time. That is called Empire Mambo, from the one and only Adolfo Indacochea. And basically, after winning one competition in Mexico, it was the world salsa competition called Euroson. After being in this competition, I met Adolfo in person for the very first time, and I got for the first time the feeling that I wanted to move somewhere else outside my country to continue my training. And at this point, I had another job that I previously studied, software engineering. So I was working in things more related to this area, but I would just keep dance as a hobby on the side and basically do it every day after I would finish working. So I decided to move to New York City, and in New York City I was able to train in Empire Mambo. Not only was I able to learn a lot of the high energetic and powerful movements that characterize New York salsa, but I was also able to learn a lot of the core foundations of cornerwork dancing, which I had never seen it being taught in such a detailed manner until I came here to New York City. And after being here in New York for about 1 year, I would say I started being reached out to be able to teach and perform professionally in different congresses, whether it was here in the United States as well as countries outside the US, in basically every continent. And now I've been there for currently 2 years and a half, and now I have recently opened my own studio where we're teaching classes online. That it is called D&Y Salsa Academy, where we give online group lessons. We teach weekly. If you want to take your training to the next level and you want to train directly with us, we're able to watch you through the video and give you live feedback, as well as answer any questions that you might have. But maybe you don't live in New York City, or you're not planning to move here anytime soon, you can train with us wherever you are in the world. Just check out the link that I will leave in the description down below. Now, two very important tips that I would say are crucial for you to be able to learn as fast as possible. I think one tip for you that I would give is to compete. Competition is very popular in many parts of the world nowadays. And I'd say, like, when you're in high school and you're learning a subject and you're going to class, but they give you exams or they give you a project deadline, you have to create something to be able to show on that date. It forces you to kind of put into application everything that you have learned into a project that you have to show by a certain deadline. So I think the competition for me is not about winning. It's not about showing that you're better than somebody else. I mean, I have won myself 12 world titles throughout my salsa career, but I think one world title doesn't even have a fraction of the value that it has the amount of training that I made because of the competition that I had ahead. So I think really competing helps you put a deadline in your calendar where you are gonna be able to train harder for this goal, to achieve this goal. So I think it is a very useful tool to make yourself prioritize your training in a way that you're able to show a good job in the competition. And this whole process, I promise you, will make you grow a lot faster than you think. Now, the second tip that I can give you is online training. When I was in the pandemic, every in-person studio was shut down, of course. I'm sure in almost everywhere, if not everywhere in the world, all the studios were shut down and it was not possible to learn in person. So online classes became a very popular thing. Now, I thought in the beginning that maybe online classes weren't gonna be the same as being in person because you can't see the person in front of you. But I think technology is now at a point where you can really see in high resolution and hear with very good audio quality your teacher, and they can see you as well. So I had the opportunity to take online classes with some of my favorite instructors, and they would be able to look at me in the online class like they were thousands and thousands of miles away in a different time zone, and they were able to give me feedback live on the things that I was doing so that I could fix the bad habits that I had. So I think if you are already in a studio in person, if you're able to take as well online classes with one of your favorite instructors, that is very powerful because that will save you a lot of time down the road. And even more important, if you don't have a very good in-person studio available next to you, I think online classes now bring you very good quality training to your living room. So really, there's no excuse now to be able to have access to great quality training. So yes, let me know if you have any questions for me. Yeah, so that's basically how I got to where I am right now. And I feel like I'm basically just starting out in my salsa journey. I'm 25 years old at the time of this recording, so I have a very long way to go, still a lot more learning to do. And also, I hope to be able to teach in more and more countries around the world to be able to share this passion that I have for the dance. So if you have any questions, just put them in the comments down below. I will promise that I will respond to every single one of them myself. And if you enjoyed this video and you would like more content like this, subscribe and like to support the channel, and I will see you next time. Bye bye.